was going to search the room, but then it was game time over, so.
Gotcha.
I was going to search the room. But I'll look at Boar's, say, it seems like Nergway might be in some trouble. We should probably go find her and see what's going on.
Yes, we should. Lead the way.
I'm going to search the room.
He knew he would. So, he stands there and watches you search the room.
Okay.
And as you search the room, in the room itself, you find, next to his bed, you find a potion of cure moderate wounds. And under his mattress, you find 250 gold pieces in a pouch.
All right, I'll,
You find...
Tell Boris that.
250 gold
pieces. You better be better than that.
In a pouch. Are you, he would say, are you ready to... Alright,
you find... Tell Boris that.
250 gold
pieces. Money's for the team.
Alright, I'll remember that. And he walks out.
This lot of it anyway. The Duke will follow him out.
Okay. Alright, so Allie. You you cast detect magic.
Detect magic.
And you were able to tell that indeed there was magic in the room.
Okay.
And then another time period goes by, and you're able to tell that the magic is definitely from the scimitar itself.
Okay.
Dun dun dun. And Rowan, you see him working on figuring that out, but also you've got Nergue laying on around next to you. So what? Where is your focus at this point? Well, we can unmute you now. So what? Where is your focus at this point? Yep, Nergway is stable. Well, we can unmute you now. So what? Where is your focus at this point? Yep, Nergway is stable. So Rowan asked Oberon what he found out.
It is magical.
So Rowan asked Oberon what he found out.
You want me to do about it?
You have spellcraft. Doesn't that
It is magical.
Identifying
magical?
Oh,
it does.
Sure. Yeah.
Rowan asked Oberon what he found out.
Yes. Okay. So I get. Do you want me to try to identify it?
I think that's a great idea.
That okay, great.
All right.
Christian, can I ask a quick question?
Go ahead.
For this little synopsis that you want me to write up about, you know, what happened and where we were, you said something about items found. Are you talking about, like, key items, or should I say everything everyone's found, or, like... Like, the dude just found a potion. Should I write down the potion, or did you just mean, like, you know, stuff about the story?
If you can handle everything that was found, that would be ideal. But at the very least, yeah, key items.
I mean, obviously I'll only be able to do it if it's revealed to the whole group, but...
Correct.
Okay. So that was just a potion and gold?
Yeah.
Okay.
But if it's, like, things that... specific items that go along with more of the story type thing, like maybe a ruin or whatever, that should be noted for sure.
Right, that's what I figured.
Yeah.
A little mundane stuff.
So.
Okay.
Yeah. So back to Oberon, and what he's telling Rowan, because we're still really on Rowan's turn, but Oberon is finding out as he's sitting there that he's able to tell that the Scimitar is not evil. There's no evil magic emanating from this object. But this one's a head scratcher for Oberon. It really intrigues you. But you are at this point, who knows what it is? Maybe it's, you know, where you're at, your situation in this dark dank dungeon and everything going on around you, but you just can't focus on figuring out what it is at this point.
But
I don't know. Your interest is piqued. That's how you're feeling about that. And so, Maria, what is Larissa and Jack doing as this is unfolding?
Jack's just staying out of the way at this point. Larissa's gonna come back up the hall and just keep an eye on Nerigwe. Make sure he continues breathing and is stable.
Okay.
Alright, and Duke?
I'm standing outside the hallway, so I guess I'm standing behind Larissa.
Okay.
Kinda watching what unfolds.
Okay, so you're... roll a perception check for me.
No.
Yeah.
Okay. 21.
Okay, so you, you hear Rowan asking Oberon what he found out, and maybe Oberon kind of mumbling to himself, "This one's strange," and you know, you don't have much more information than that because it hasn't been given, and obviously you see Nerigwe there, laying on the ground asleep, and. Seems to be breathing, seems fine, but, yeah, that's what you notice around you.
Mm-hmm.
Do you do anything else with that?
Larissa, what's going on?
Weren't you in the room when I told Boris what happened?
I was a little preoccupied.
Oh, okay, sorry. Well,
out of character, okay, if you did, I'm sorry, I missed that, so...
Okay.
You just feel like, I've already told you, and that's...
Rowan was searching this room, and she found the scimitar, which she was going to give to Nerigwe, and just before she handed it to Nerigwe, Nerigwe passed out, and the scimitar started screaming, so... Rowan threw it in the corner, and Oberon is now trying to figure it out. Nerigwe seems okay. Passed out cold.
That's kind of crazy.
Yeah, it's really creepy.
Probably best we don't touch that.
Yeah, I'm not touching it. We'll leave that to Oberon.
Thanks!
like the way you think.
Okay, so now I've got... Tara seems to be in the call, but character's not showing up on the Roll20 screen. As you know, at the bottom where it lists all the players. All right, what's your status there, Tara? Rebooted twice. Do you see the game on your screen? All black and white squares. That's awesome. I'm going to try to bring us off of the page. No, that won't help. Well, actually... Okay. Oh, she left. So at this point, Nergway begins to stir. And Boris kind of leans against the wall to look around everyone standing in the hallway to see what's going on. And he's just making sure everything's okay. And as he looks around and sees Nergway beginning to stir, he takes a few, about 10 steps back down the hallway just to take up the rear, to make sure no one's coming up behind us. And that's what he's concerned about. And so, yeah. Allie, what...
Solid 2 minutes, I would be just focused on your grave. Waiting for it to wake up, so...
Yeah.
That's what I'll be doing until...
Mm-hmm.
Anything changes.
Okay.
Looking very distraught.
Yep. Alright. Tara, welcome back. You are starting to stir. And it looks like you're actually in the game now, so that's a good thing. You are muted.
Oh, can there anyone hear me?
Yes, we can.
Yay! My screen is still all black and white, so someone might have to move me, but... Okay. When it comes time for me to be able to move. So what I don't know if anyone got my message before, but Rowan was able to touch the scimitar without being harmed. Is that correct?
That is correct.
So maybe it's an orc-specific thing or a non-human-specific? Or no. Rowan's human, right? Or she's half-elf.
Yeah, something like that.
I don't know. Maybe it's species-specific.
Yeah, I think she's at least half-elf, right?
I mean, if it does anyone else feel sick when coming near it, or...
Oh, she's an elf. Full elf.
Yeah, she's an elf.
Are we assuming that Oberon touched it while he was examining it, too?
Oberon is definitely, at the very least, you know, 5 feet away from it or less. You know, he's checking it out. I don't know, it's up to you, David, whether or not you've touched it or not. But you are, I mean, you're definitely, I would say... within proximity that it could be affecting you if it were going to.
Did I touch it, or did
you did not touch it. You did not touch it. Your hand came about 6 inches away before it screamed and you passed out.
Right. Okay, so the detect magic
did that it could be a...
I touch it, or did I...
You did not touch it. You did not touch
an item. I don't know. I'm not sure what you... have to do for that, but
I'm not either.
Common sense. Like I wouldn't rush in and just like, hey, I think it knocked out this big half orc. I think I'll just start handling it. You know what I mean?
No.
Yeah, but
right,
if you're still about the same distance from it, then I'm wondering if. Sorry, go ahead, Christian.
I'm just thinking. I think we're all just sort of thinking it out. You know, I would think if you were examining it. You are, you know, definitely being very careful about it, but step by step, you're inching forward using all of your senses to examine it completely. So yeah, again, while you may not have, you know, touched it yet, I would say during your examination, as the process goes on, you're close enough to it at least that, you know, it could be affecting you if it were going to.
Both full elves? Both of you are full elves? Are you an elf, Oberon?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I mean, I think I have natural resistance to something.
It's an elf scimitar, yeah. Yep.
Yeah. Immune to magic, elves are immune to magic sleep effects.
Mm.
Well, that could help too.
And racial saving throw bonus against enchantment spells and effects.
I'm reading. She dropped out again. But I'm reading everything Rowan is typing there. So
yeah. If it does cause sleep, it won't cause me to go to sleep.
If that's what it is, I guess. I guess you can always chuck it at one of your friends to see what happens. let's check this out.
That's weird. Hey, I made that post. Yeah, right.
Yeah. Okay. So let's see. Where are we at? So Maria, what do you think the next step should be?
I think it's best to not touch the scimitar. Since we have no idea what it is. And you said that Nergway is starting to wake up?
Yep. Maybe now sort of sitting on his elbows, leaning back as he wakes up.
So I'm going to ask him if he feels okay.
What happened?
Passed out, dude.
Just like that.
Well, Rowan tried to hand you that scimitar, and before you even touched it, you were on the ground.
Here he runs up and gives Nergal a big hug.
Where's the scimitar now?
In your back.
Oh, is it in my bag?
No, it's not. Is anyone going to answer Nergway?
I think they chucked it in that room, further in the room. Not really sure.
So I'm going to slowly walk toward that room that Sly indicated. And step by step, because I'm still feeling nauseous. And I'm going to walk slowly in there to try to figure out what's going on. I'm just going to ease right next to Rowan. And I see the scimitar now. So, Oberon, can you tell me anything about what's going on here?
It's magical. And apparently, it is, unless you're suffering from a severe case of narcolepsy, I think you falling asleep had something to do with the magic from this scimitar. Well, other than that, I can't quite make heads or tails of it.
Is it making anyone else fall asleep?
I think we're all awake.
Mhm. All right.
So I think it's just you. But if I had to guess, I would keep Boris away from it.
Oh, why is that?
Call it a wild guess, but I don't know, maybe there are certain members of our group which won't be able to withstand its effects.
Hmm. Myself and Boris, you mean the warriors?
Yeah.
Hmm. So should we just leave it behind?
That's a nice way of saying it. Yeah, maybe you should.
That's a nice way of saying it? So what's the not nice way of saying it?
I don't, maybe people with lower constitution or people who are you know, not resistant to magic, you know, maybe people who are more susceptible to magic, maybe, I don't know, affected more easily, I guess.
And David, Oberon, as he's talking to Nergue and maybe still looking at the scimitar, begins to notice that it's quite a fine quite fine craftsmanship, and it's just you've seen Nergue's, wow, this is gonna sound bad, you've seen Nergue's scimitar many times, and this was just so much better, and
yeah,
but more so than just that, the fact that it's really, really a great scimitar, the magic aspect of it and the unknown power that it seems to have, and also that scream, that a screaming scimitar, the magic aspect of it,
your curiosity,
the
is
unknown bubbling over. Power that it seems to have,
uncontrollable,
and also that scream,
okay.
That
out of context,
a screaming scimitar, the magic aspect of it,
your curiosity,
the unknown bubbling power that it seems to have, uncontrollable, and also that scream, that
context,
a screaming scimitar. So, Boars calls back, we should probably check the rest of these rooms to make sure they're clear and that there's nothing else we need and get a move on.
Okay. Sounds good. Who wants to take the sword?
No, I'm good.
Not me.
I was going to say while they were all talking, I was going to check these two doors here for...
Okay. Cool. All right. Why don't you do... You can do two separate check for trap ones rolls if you want. Okay. So you perceive no traps on
the one I'm in front of.
The one you're in front of.
And the other one.
And the other one, you perceive no traps there either.
All right.
So would you like to open those doors?
Sure. I'll open this one slowly.
Okay.
Over here. Can't really get myself in there.
See what we can do here.
Okay. Oh.
So you see inside that room. Do do do. Wow. This bedroom has a faint, musty odor. The bed is covered with matted gray and black hair, and bloodstains mar the stone floor, while a morbid stack of bird's feet lie heaped on the floor on the side of the bed.
Ew.
Gross.
And roll a perception check for me.
Okay.
You remember that looking in at the bed there, the hair that you see on it looks an awful lot like the creature that you just encountered with the goblin wives. Seems to be the same, you know, consistency and coloring. just a little fact you think of.
Okay.
So, all right. We'll leave that at that for now.
All right.
And Rowan, is there anything specific you'd like to do? I'm jumping everywhere, but I'm just trying to give each of you a little bit of time because you're popcorning on me, which is cool.
Popcorning?
Well,
popping all over the place.
Yeah, it's one person's turn, but they're interacting with another one, so it kind of becomes their turn, and it goes back and forth. So instead of being able to just go through the list of names, I'm trying to just make sure everyone gets some time. So.
Capiche.
She wants Obi to take the scimitar.
Of course she does.
What do you think of that, Oberon?
I don't know how heavy it is. Let me see. I have to be careful about how much I carry here. Let me...
She's also volunteered to go ahead and just take it, because obviously she can handle it.
Okay.
If you didn't see that in the chat.
Okay, yeah. Do that. That also.
So do you pick it up and hand it to her, or do you move out of the way?
I'll let her grab it. I'll move out of the way. Okay. It's not evil or anything.
That's what you have ascertained.
Like, apparently I'm also moving Nergwe. Come on, Nergwe.
Come on, Nergwe.
This is fun. I don't know how I did it. All right. Must be when I got married, I got control of my wife.
And that was the last time that we ever heard
of Oberon die. Slow and painful death. Oh. All right. So the scimitar is in Rowan's possession.
And Rowan is still conscious.
And Rowan is still conscious. And feeling just fine. Alright. So, let's see. Cheery, is there anything you would like to do?
Not really. I'm ready to move on. Everybody else's.
Okay. Duke, did you want to check that other room or does somebody else?
No, I was going to check it. I was just waiting.
All right, so let's go ahead and reveal the room. And as you open the door, this room is clean and well organized. A low dresser in the southwest has a stack of papers sitting atop it, weighted down by a large chunk of obsidian, while to the northwest a well-made bed stands.
Okay, I want to search the room. I want to look through those papers too, more specifically as well.
Okay.
Oh. Sorry. Premature rolling there. Didn't know what I was rolling for.
I'm just going to go ahead and roll.
Yep.
So the papers on the desk, or on the nightstand rather, are what appear to be rough drafts of Sudo's plans to blackmail his father and to use the glassworks as a staging ground for the coming investigation of the catacombs that you are now in. Actually, not these catacombs. The catacombs of Wrath from earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Not news to you, really, but you can deduce that this is probably Sudo's former room at this base.
Gotcha. Do I find anything else in the room?
You find nothing else of interest in the room.
I'm going to take the papers, the plans, the drafts. Mm-hmm. I'm going to... Is Larissa, are you still standing outside the door?
I am.
Okay. I'm going to poke my head out and hold out the papers, and I'm like, I think I just found Sudo's room, and these are the rough drafts of his plan and stuff like that. Do you think we should take these back to Hemlock?
Yes, I think that'd be a good idea. Hold on to those.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll stuff those on my person.
All right, so you have cleared this quadrant of the map. So Boris says, let's go, guys. Let's check out the rest of this place. I'll take up the rear. So where do we want to... I'm going to zoom out a little bit. Back in the main room that we all kind of started in. There were some other options.
We already checked all those doors. We just closed them, didn't we?
Yes, correct.
Okay.
So let's see. Now I'll start at the beginning of the list here. Larissa, what do you think we should do? Where should we go? So you point to the door, I'll open it, Boris says.
So the red doors are the ones we've already explored, correct?
No.
Well, we just
closed them.
Yeah, we opened them, made sure they were not trapped, and we closed them behind us.
And these are stairs going up or down?
The stairs, those are the ones
we came down.
Those
are the ones we came down, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. How about this door? Check out this way.
I'm fine with it. We have to try them all eventually.
Yep,
so.
Alright, Boris. You go first. I'm right behind you.
Oh, now I'm going to take up the rear.
Alright, let's get Nergway up here. She can go first.
You think, Nergway, are you going to be able to take care of that?
Nergway is a boy.
Be the trailblazer?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I'm sick.
Yeah.
Yes, I will. Oops, I just killed myself.
You just killed yourself. Goodbye, cruel world!
So, I'm leading the way.
If he's feeling okay.
I'm trying to take that. Can I take this thing off me, or is it? Am I cursed in some way?
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're cursed.
Well, can you move yourself from where you're at right now? Because there's remnants of dead body there, and I can't. There you go. Oh,
there it goes.
Wow, he's dancing all over.
I got it.
All right. Let's get Jack. I'm gonna move Jack for you.
Oh yeah, thank you.
And Rowan, if you don't mind, I'll put you back up in the room with... Oh, you already did. Okay. Wow, Nergway. I know who's doing that. Why is this possible?
What?
Unbelievable.
I'm trying to help.
Great. Let's see. Hold on. So we've decided to head...
We're heading this way?
To the right. Yep.
Okay, so I need... Are my hit points really this low? What happened to me last game?
I have gotten hit a couple of times.
Alright. Just leading the way here.
Alright, so I'm going to remove that little red dot. And I'm going to reveal a little bit more, at least, as you guys make your way into the area. So, somebody actually going to enter the room?
I just did.
Nope.
I did.
Over here.
I didn't hear that?
Over here.
Ping where here is.
I am.
Ping.
To the right.
It's the room without the red door.
Oh, this one?
No, that I'm facing. I'm right in front of it.
Okay, let me find you. Oh, this room. I'm way in the wrong way. Okay, I'll come around. This room?
Wow.
Where did he go?
Way back where you guys were just at.
Okay. Can you pick him up and move him, GM, just so
I'm moving him. And then I'm going to...
This room?
No, stop it!
You said the room Larissa's facing, which could be this room.
There. This room. Right there.
That's where I am.
Now? Yeah,
well, now that's where I put you. Oh, now you're out in the middle of the island. Stop it!
What? I don't...
All right, I said I'm going to bed. Forget it.
I thought it was leading us somewhere. I'm leading us into a room where we all are. Are these stairs?
All right, so as you enter this area, and I believe we kind of described this area last time, but you weren't here, so because you guys peeked through the door, but... Crates, barrels, and mounds of miscellaneous refuse lie heaped against the walls here. To the north, the sounds of crashing surf echoes.
Okay.
Are we going to trudge along? Push forward?
Has anyone searched the crates yet?
No.
I would like to search the crates.
Okay.
Yeah. I will come in and assist in helping with the search.
Okay. There's raw materials here. Obviously pieces of wood, and there's some metals that could be made into weapons and whatnot, or maybe turned into armor. For the most part, this room is mostly just refuse and junk that looks, you know, it's like somebody's hoard, garbage hoard. So.
All right.
So, can we see anything to the north here now?
Well, as you come in further, do the rest of you? Let's see. All right, let me get this going. Duke, are you going to sort of hang back a bit, or do you follow them, or what's your plan?
I'll follow them in there and do a detailed search of the room.
Okay.
While they're looking through barrels.
Yep, while everything, yep. And you all...
I was actually searching the room, not necessarily the barrels.
Okay, never mind. I will assist you then, assisting the rest of the party.
Again, as you all spend time in the room looking at everything... You find exactly what I've described thus far, and that's it. No more.
All right.
So, whether you're looking at barrels, or you're looking at boxes, or you're looking at walls, or you're looking at floor or ceiling, you see what I have told you. So, all right.
Okay. I haven't found much over here. Bunch of junk.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And
picks up some metal and drops it on the floor.
Yep. Cool. And Cheery, what do you want to do?
Sounds like they're not finding much in there. I don't want to be underfoot, so I'll wait out here until, keep, you know, an eye on these other doors until we, move on.
Okay. All right. And Sir David of Lewis.
Yeah, you rang.
What does Obi want to do?
I think I'm gonna follow Nergway in and detect magic.
Okay. And you detect no magic in the room.
Okay.
All right. And Rowan? What would you like to do? All right. Watching the doors. Good idea. And Bors is going to stay back here and make sure Rowan and Cheery are all right, and also keeps eyeing down the passageway toward Nergue and Oberon and all the rest too. Just trying to keep an eye on every possible opportunity of something to go south. So, yeah. All right. So you in the storage area there, you see to the north another little passage that leads north and toward the sound of the crashing waves.
So I'm going to say, hey, Nergue, you see this over here?
Nargul.
Sorry, you were cutting out. I only heard half of that.
Did you see this walkway over here? Tunnel?
Yes.
That out?
The tunnel? Where Rowan is?
Nope, that's a room. Tunnel to the north.
North tunnel.
Up.
Come to here?
No, the room we were just in.
This one.
Yes.
There's a tunnel? To the north of it. This is the tunnel?
Where are you?
I'm still in that
You're
room.
You're back down in the room again.
I didn't put me there.
David.
What?
There's a tunnel?
Did you do that?
No, I haven't touched
it. To the north of it.
No, I swear.
This is the tunnel?
Where are you?
But I'm still in that
room.
You're married. It's okay now.
I didn't put me there.
David, it's evil.
Are we talking about
what?
Stop.
There's a tunnel?
Did you do that?
No, I haven't touched
it. To the north of it. This is the tunnel?
Where are you?
But I'm
still in that room. Right. Okay, right here. Now, do you see that?
Okay.
I'm dying here too.
Where'd Nergoy go?
Right here. Okay. Right beside you.
Nope. Okay. Yeah, but do you see the way to go now?
Well, nothing's being. I'm in the room, but there's no tunnel showing to the north of me. There's just blackness.
There must be something going.
Where you're in, but oh, oh wait, no, you moved now, but close.
You totally cut out. Oh, now it's showing. Now I see the tunnel. That explains why I didn't see it before, because it was not there for me. And now I've gone as far as I can without it being just blackness.
Okay, yes, let me reveal some more.
Can we take that, go this way off now?
Then I have 60 feet of dark vision.
Yeah, there's also line of sight involved.
I'm following up with Nergoy, as well as Jack.
What do you think, Duke?
Oberon, you should probably grab the others. There's a tunnel that they're all going off into.
Okay.
And I will wait in this room for the others.
Okay. All right.
I'm going to turn around and yell to the group, yo group, let's go. Our party's moving on. And, you know, forward in here. Seems to be safe since everybody else is in here.
Mm-hmm. God. And Boris says, let's go, ladies. It sounds like we're going this way.
And I'm going to take out my weapon.
Nergoy, are you going to move ahead?
If I have anything other than blackness in front of me, I will. But right now, that's all I got.
Really?
Really, really.
I mean, there should be one, two, three, at least three squares, four squares heading northeast.
Nope, just black. I'll refresh if you'd like.
Does everyone else see a little bit more tunnel?
Yeah.
Yep.
You could head down? Okay.
Yep.
Any better, Nergoy?
Much worse, in fact. Now I like have black and white squares, and I don't see myself or anyone else.
What the devil?
That scimitar must have done a real doozy on you.
Black and white sparkles.
I'm now colorblind. Maybe that's what it did to me.
Mm. Well, while I guess that gets figured out, I'll go. Your plan was to move forward, correct? So
yes. So please move me. And all you know, right, if I see a bad guy, kill him. You know.
Nergoy smash.
You know what to do. It's not complicated.
So. All right. So we're gonna reveal a bit more. And indeed, as Nergoy moves forward, he calls back.
I see a monster.
We've got something creepy back here.
Ooh, a tentamort. Hang on, let me get my phone. I want to catch it.
Wow. All right, so everyone roll initiative.
I'm just going to want to catch it.
Alright, I reloaded again, and I can see some things now. So if I can find myself, yep, I did. I rolled my own initiative.
Okay.
Now I can see things. I don't know.
Natural one.
Awesome.
It's a natural one.
I'm just gonna stare at my shoes.
We should have taken that scimitar.
Yeah.
Oh, shoot. Alright, so looks like everyone is on there, right?
No.
Guys. All right, Cheery. Lead us to victory.
Yes, hopefully. All right, hearing Nergway's warning. Move. Guessing there's no way. No glass.
Yeah, you can kind of lean. Hug this wall and you'd be okay.
All right, I'll take it.
Well, if you want to argue, I suppose.
No. Although I might have been able to move to the square in front of me. If you do. I mean, is this thing obviously hostile or?
It hasn't done anything at this point. Why don't you, do you have knowledge of dungeoneering?
Let me see. 23.
I have knowledge of dungeoneering.
You know.
I think we all took that.
You know that this is a tentamort. That. It's an aberration.
Oh, nice.
Is it an evil creature? Is that an aberration?
Yes, yeah. It is an evil creature.
Alright, well, it's hostile and shoot it.
Okay.
Or, well, that's Nerdblade.
It's an
aberration. Can I shoot it, or do we want to try to sneak up on it? I don't know if it... Well, has it noticed us?
It has.
All right, I'm gonna... Four damage.
Yeah, I can go kill him, but it's my turn.
Not at all.
Okay. Bors. Bors is going to take up the rear. So he's just moving up behind Rowan.
The
Duke. Stop.
Well, it's a tight squeeze in there, so I'm just going to move up behind Larissa. And I'll say, I'll be around if you need me, and go stealth.
Okay.
21.
Right. You don't know. But you don't know.
Nope.
You're looking around. All right. Pentamort. Okay. Jack and Larissa.
Alright. Well, I'm going to try this. It may not work, but I'm going to give it a shot. Larissa is going to use the scroll of command that she found.
Ooh.
And direct it. Wait. Oh, wait. She's got to get closer first. Let's see. Range. 25 feet plus 5 feet every 2 levels. What are we, level 3?
Mm-hmm.
And what's my... I think I'm good at the 25, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 feet there. I'm close enough. And one living creature. It lasts one round. Will negates. And what it does is it gives... There's specific commands that I can give this creature, which it will have to obey to the best of its ability and it's at its earliest opportunity. So I am going to use the command approach, which means that on its turn, it will move toward me as quickly and as directly as possible for one round, and it may do nothing but move, and it provokes attacks of opportunity.
Nice. Way to go.
Dope.
So,
okay.
That's what I am doing.
Okay. You got that, Evil? Yep. All right.
Now he can try a will save. It did say that. It said will negates. Saving throw will negates.
All right. Why don't you roll it, Jack? Pentamort Evil. 14. What was the DC?
Didn't say.
I think it was 15. Yeah. Yep.
Rowan. Right away.
That's usually for 15 for spells, isn't it? That sort of thing.
In that general vicinity. So, all right, I'm cool with it. Let's move on.
Play it out.
Yep, sounds fun. And Jack.
And Jack is gonna go ahead and fly up and attack it. Caw-caw.
Caw-caw. Nice.
Okay. So it's 4 damage.
Slashes out at him. Maybe pulls off one tentacle. And Oberon and Khan.
Okay. I think
I'm sorry, but Rowan discovered that the will save for that was actually 14. Okay. Not 15.
Next time we play it, that'll be the way we play it.
5, 10, 15, 20. Okay. 25. Okay, I can't even move there. So I will move up to where I can move up to and peek over their heads. What's going on? What's up there? What's going on? What is it? Does anybody say anything?
Something for Nergue to smash.
I don't know what it is. It has lots of tentacles. It definitely looks evil. I should kill it. That's what I think.
Oh, that tentacles. That sounds dangerous.
It doesn't look friendly, Oberon.
All right, Oberon, what do you want to do?
Yeah, that's it. That's all I can do.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, we're done.
Okie doke. And anything with Khan?
No, we can't. I can't really get in there, so... Okay. I can't move enough spaces, so I can't even get in there, so...
Gotcha.
We're done.
Okay. All right, but Nergway.
All right. Nergway smash.
Yay!
I can be under Jack, so...
Mm-hmm.
Smash button. Boop.
Smash button.
Yeah, that's a hit.
Okay. And as you move... Damage 4. Damage 15. Holy cow. Alright. So, is he... He's not dead. No. So, as you move forward to whack at it, you are able to see around the corner a bit. And we add another bit of joy.
There's another one. This guy has a brother. Or a sister. Maybe it's his mom. I don't know. But there's another one.
All right. And it's turn.
It's gonna move on over.
Oh boy.
That's
I don't think that's a hit. That was
no
cute. Hey guys, they just tickled me with their tentacles. Get it?
Wow.
They just gave me 10 tickles.
All right, Rowan.
Hardy har har.
Hardy
har har.
Fails miserable moon. Trouble. Okay.
I assume the failure was talking about the tentacle guys, not herself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was like, ah. Okay, getting in position. All right, round two. Cheery.
Cheery will. Let's see. Move over here and shoot at Tentaport 1 is the one that's Larissa cast on, right? Tentaport 4 is the new one.
Yeah.
All right. I'll shoot at Tentaport 4.
Yay, it's the Star Trek song.
I'm not hearing any music anymore.
Yeah, me neither, but I might have turned it down and heard it more.
Alright, that is all.
And Boars moves up. And let's see. Nat 20 sees the Duke.
Oh, okay.
And says, "What do you think, Duke?"
Her eyes are very wide in her thing, and she's like, "I don't know what's going on up there. I'm just standing right here. Somebody's getting tickled by something."
That's what I heard.
I don't like to be tickled.
No. No. All right. Duke, it's your turn. What do you want to do?
I will move one step closer to Boris. It's kind of tight in that hallway right there. I don't think that's great battle plan strategy, so I'm just gonna... That's all for me.
You guys remember that you can pass through squares that your friendlies are, you know, in, right?
Right.
You just have to have a square after them to land in.
Yeah.
I wasn't talking to you in, you know, specifically. I'm just making sure. Because everyone tends to just line up in a hallway instead of passing through and filling a room. So, just making sure. All right. Ten to Mort.
So opportunity from Jack, Narragway, Cheery. Right?
Let me think about this. He would probably go there. Now he's stepping into Cheery's threatened area, not through. So Jack and Narragway, though, for sure.
I'm just going to move Jack so that way Narragway can access his character.
Okay. Narragway smash and Jack smash. Three damage. Rips off another tentacle.
Uh-oh.
And Narragway, are you going to take your attack of opportunity?
You bet your ass I am.
All right.
That's critical. Bitch.
It does not confirm, though, so.
12 damage. Come on. Not for long.
All right. So it is Jack's turn.
Oh, yeah. You go, Jack.
And Jack, this time now, is going to go after the 4.
Okay.
Ooh.
All right. And Larissa.
And Larissa is going to take a swing at 1.
Hit it with your stick.
I don't have a stick anymore.
Oh, your scythe.
Nope.
No. All right, Obi and Khan.
All right, I am going to move up, and Khan is going to get my square, and from here. Can I shoot him from here? It looks like I can. With the acid dart?
Yes.
Alright. Well, then that's what I'm going to do. Oh, acid.
Oh, yeah.
The wizard's on a tear, man.
All right. And as Jack had moved up to attack this one, another Tentamort saw him fly into view.
Great.
All right. And it is Nergway's turn. Good job, Obi.
Yay.
Yeah. Nice one, wizard. I'll get this one for you.
Go get him.
That might be a miss. I don't know.
I don't think they can laugh, but okay. All right, and Tentamort 4.
That's a hit. Okay. Save.
Yep.
I did it. Okay, now I'm going to kill you, you little bitch.
Put your feather dusters away, kids. You love us.
Nice. Rowan. Shoot it, no phone. Your shot whizzes past it through its flippy, floppy, dangling tentacles and hits the cave wall. And round three, Cheery.
Cheery will move over here. Give everybody a little more room. And shoot at 10.4. 14.
Okay. And Boars moves up behind the wrist. That's it. Duke.
I'm gonna move. Let's see. Oh, there's a little bit more room up here. Oh, crap. Is that what we're fighting? And that's going to end my turn, because that's as far as I can go. I can't go back.
Okay.
She has her rapiers out, so.
Gotcha. Okay. Tentamort 3. Okay. And I accidentally... Jack and Larissa.
Okay, Larissa is going to come up behind Nergway and imbue him with resistance, which means that it will protect him from harm, granting a plus one resistance on bonus saves, which will help if it the poison from the Tentamort. So, Nergway, you need to make sure you have a you add a plus one to those saves. And that's for 1 minute.
I add a plus one to what for 1 minute?
Your saves, like if it was a will save or a fortitude save.
Understood.
Okay.
And... And, Allie, you may... This doesn't say specifically that she can... That it's only used once.
For what?
This particular one for resistance, it doesn't say that it can only be used once. It just says for 1 minute. So that means she gets the plus one for that entire 1 minute?
Yeah. If it doesn't say 1 minute, like the ones that are only used once say 1 minute or until discharged. So
right.
Like the guidance and stuff. So yeah, that should be for 1 minute.
Right. Right, like there's another one over here that says 1 minute or until discharged. So.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Nerva, make note that you've got that plus one on your saves.
For like
that
gotcha. Sounds, basically.
Well, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, so, basically.
So.
Oh.
I caught it. I'm just showing you all. Got a CP of 450.
Yeah, Tara, once y'all download Pokemon Go, you'll understand. So
I have deduced anyway.
Yeah. So that is all that Larissa is going to do.
Okay.
And Jack is going to go after Tentamount 4. Alright. There's the music.
And then it's Oberon's turn.
Alright.
Plan.
Yeah, I'm gonna move up.
Hawk and dog.
Wow. And con. This was 15, 20, 30. Ah, you can't move anywhere. Damn. Okay. All right. I don't think I can. If I try to shoot here, am I going to hit Jack or somebody else?
No.
An acid dart. Okay. I'm going to shoot acid dart then.
Okay. It will take a negative 4 penalty to the attack roll.
Oh!
So
right.
11.
I already did it.
Yeah. No, it doesn't. Okay. It doesn't waste anything, right? Yeah.
Okay. Alright. We're done. We're both done.
Okay. Nergway.
Yes. Nergway.
Have you put away your Nerf swords and taken out your scimitar?
Scimitar is out.
Okay.
It's like the rubber sword that Jon Snow used in the Battle of.
Oh, sorry. It's still the Nerf sword. Damn.
Man. Mm-hmm. All right. Tentamort 4.
Thank you. Don't forget that plus one. Which was that? Was that
40? Whoa. Okay, so the 4 comes off of your constitution, not your hit points. Yep. And you are nauseated for 2 rounds.
Oh, Nergoy has a tummy ache.
Mm. All right, and Rowan. You can take it out. No, you can pull it out of your backpack, and then I wouldn't move forward because then it's going to attack you on its turn. So I would just pull it out, and then your next turn move forward and hit.
Pulling something out of your bag, I believe, is a move action. So do a move in a standard or 2 moves. You have to move to attack the bag.
Right, she's not standing next to it. She'd have to step forward. So.
Oh, man.
Okay, got it. Cheery.
Cheery will shoot at... And what for?
Okay.
Alright.
And... Boars. Crud. As soon as I open something up to try to read it, I have to do something. That would be further than... That won't be stepping through any... thing. Yeah, it would be.
Yeah, it would.
Alright, I'm gonna stay put. Take up the rear. Duke.
Can't Boris come to this one right here?
Rowan has made it known that she's going to be doing that, so...
Oh, okay.
Want to step on any toes.
While everybody is kind of in front of the Duke is going to try to stealth herself a little bit better. With a 34.
Okay.
And she's gonna move...
That it?
That's it.
Okay. Tentmort 3.
Isn't that through one of Jack's threatened spurs?
Uh-oh.
Alrighty.
Jack of opportunity.
Caw-caw. Oh. And that was an overrun.
Oh, you only got a 9? Yeah, that's a no.
Yeah, that's a no.
Okay. Then it's Jack, right? Yeah, Jack.
Jack is going to... go again after 4. And Larissa is going to put her hand on Cherry's shoulder and use guidance on her, which gives her a +1 competence bonus on a single attack roll, saving throw, or skill check. So this is the one where, Cherry, you have to say you're using it.
Got it.
You have a minute to use it.
Thank you very much.
And that's a standard action. And I'm also going to use guidance on Rowan.
Okay.
So you got that, Rowan. It's what the bonus is. And you have to say you're using it.
Nope.
Hang on.
Feel the surge of confidence and strength. All right. Jack went, Larissa went, Oberon.
I'm gonna shoot.
Evil, go ahead and roll that.
I am going to shoot the one in front of me. That's a dart.
Nice.
Khan is he still alive? Khan is going to poison bite.
Right. And Nergue is throwing up in the corner.
Yep.
Is that per...
That's been the first round. One more round. You'll be throwing up next round yet, too.
And I turn to Nergue. I know how it feels, man. I know how it feels. Uh-huh.
Good job, Maria. You will.
Choose puke orange dot. There you go. All right, now.
Gross.
That's what Nergue
was. Avoid the orange dot.
Tentamort 2. has heard from its area what's going on and comes.
It's a hit. Hang on, let me fix my hit points. I'm sorry, that was a what? Saving throw. I resist.
All right. And number four.
Ugh. Oh shit. Is that a crit confirm, GM?
Well, she's about to try.
Nope.
That's the first damage.
Yeah.
So you take that off for sure. Now roll again and attack evil. Music is good right now.
Okay. Oh my goodness.
Alright, roll damage again.
Oy,
oy. I'm dead, y'all.
Well, you're not dead, are you?
I'm unconscious. I'm -3. I'm unconscious.
Okay. Right.
The poison doesn't stack, right? I mean, that's...
No.
Well, then it doesn't stack. Shut up.
All right, Rowan, you're up. Evil takes this job seriously. All right. Woo! Can't, he's unconscious. Oh, okay. Got it. Cheery. Sorry. Oh, wait. She says wait. Why didn't it work?
Oh, she's pointing the magical sleep scimitar at it.
Oh. What is that?
No, because Nerigwe didn't touch it, so... But if it...
Oh.
So she just wants to make sure if it's supposed to work that it is, you know, that it's not just a random scimitar, it's a magical one.
It doesn't... It doesn't do anything.
Okay.
There's no effect. You know, you're able to start it back up too, you know.
Where is Boars? Oh my god, okay. Do these creatures have eyes? Can they actually see us?
Yep. Did you not see the creature? She's gonna have to get it out of her bag. So.
So you can pour it down next round.
Phooey. Alright, so you're taking
assuming
it out.
Assuming pointing and waving the scimitar counter doesn't.
Yeah, I would.
Yeah.
You're reaching forward, waving it in front of its face, and then, ah, crap. And then, like, alright, and then reach back. Yeah, you're done. You're good. So, alright. So we're gonna say she ends her turn with the potion in her hand, ready to go. So, cheery.
Gonna keep, I'm gonna shoot again at, number four. There we go.
There you go, Tarkin.
There you go, Tarkin.
Okay. And you did not use your bonus on that one, correct?
No, I didn't say I was, so I didn't. Cool. Forgot about that. But it's okay.
Alright. And we're going to say it's Boar's turn, and Boar's is sick of standing around doing nothing. Slides past Rowan. And takes a whack.
Boar's just joined us, it looks like.
Uh-huh. Larry, you want to hit the button? Or you want me to?
No, he's probably still loading.
Still loading. I'll hit the button. Let's see. Do-do-do. Mount Warhammer. Great
Silly
Terabuchi.
Commodore 64.
Silly Commodore 64. Oh, no!
Wait. Can we wait for Boar's to show up? Does he have a fate chip? Does Boar's have a fate chip?
What? No!
He does have a fate chip. Oh, Shiza.
GM, you can't break the Terabuchi.
I know I can't break the Terabuchi. I'm well aware of the Terabuchi's importance.
It's not. Boris didn't roll it, the GM rolled it. It's just like the GM can't kill you when you're having the GM sub for you. Mm-hmm. Technically.
I don't know, the house rule is the GM can't kill you when he's playing for you. It's not that he can't break your weapons.
Well, but he rolled a natural one. That's not necessarily a breaking
right.
The weapon. All
the right, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
The penalty is.
Okay, I was away from keyboard. What did I miss?
One for a boar's attack.
Oh.
Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. 33. He threw his weapon 10 feet.
Oh, jeez.
All right. He threw his weapon. Thanks, Sean, for the idea to find that chart.
Oh, did you find the did you find the Pathfinder critical generator?
No, it's just a chart. It's all this way I can print it out and have it, So, let's see. He threw it. He took a swing so hard, and it landed. That's not 10 feet. Here behind us. At least he's not broke. It's not broken.
There should also be a critical natural 21, too, that you can find.
I have it.
Oh. Hello, hello.
All right. Duke.
Is the one in front of me, the Tenemort 3, is that the one that took Nergue down?
I think that was 4.
Oh.
Yeah.
I gotcha. But then there's another one coming behind him.
Man, many of these damn things.
Yeah. Oh, I'm ninja now. Right. Awesome. Yeah. I'm gonna... Jack is an ally, and I would be flanking Tentamort 3, right?
Yep.
Sweet. Then, sneak attacks! 24... and 21. 10 and 12. Jesus Christ!
Alright, Tentamort 3 has one tentacle left. He's sort of balancing on it.
Oh, hey. Wait a minute. My second one? I got an 18? Yeah. No, I got 12 plus 9. Never mind. Sorry.
Move along.
Nothing to see there. Jesus.
Oh, come on.
What the heck?
Right. What?
Who are you attacking?
Nergway.
Oh.
Nergway.
Oh.
What was she at? He at?
-3.
-3, and then the constitution was knocked down by 4.
I think Evil's taking his jab too seriously here.
What was your constitution left, Nergway? Are you there?
I am here.
Please tell us you're not dead.
My constitution is... Which color is that? Blue or red?
I have your sheet here. Your constitution total is 15 to begin with.
Oh, shit.
Is 11.
-3.
8. And we're taking another 11 off of it.
You're dead.
What?
Yep.
Why are we taking so much off of it? How many hits did they get?
There was a crit confirm.
He crit.
Do you want to use the chart for the critical hit? Alternative.
But isn't the 11 off the hit points and the other is off the constitution, not everything off the constitution?
You're already
negative hit points.
Oh, that's right.
Great.
That's not what I wanted to roll. Hold on.
What is this?
Just hold on. All right, we're taking our break. We'll see you back at 7:15.
Okay.
All right.
Well, Nergway just died. What? I don't know, man. If I drink Henry Hart's Ard soda, I might go killing people. Don't you evil laugh at me. Wow, dude, that's rough. Kicking them when they're down. Yeah, anything worth doing is worth doing right. Oh my god! How many of those Henry's Hard Orange Sodas have you had, sir? Lightweight. Okay. Couldn't have waited until maybe the next round to try to do that. Rowan's gonna try to pour a potion down a corpse's mouth. Oh my god. Well, wow. Wow. I mean, good job as a player, but you suck as the enemy. Yep. The first non-voluntary death of the game. Wow.
Maybe Rowan, bring it way back to life.
Did you see what Rowan typed?
He learned it.
That's okay. That's okay. Now that you killed two friends of Oberon, his job is to make you like make the evil in the world so annoyed that they just give up.
I will make you suffer, evil. All of the evil. Wow.
Okay, go for it. I dare you.
Whoa.
I triple dog dare you. Come and
Ryan,
get it, BF.
Ryan, there's the flagpole is right there, Ryan. What are you going to do? You going to put your tongue against it or not?
That's right. Come and get it, Biash.
You killed my wife's character! You will suffer! So, Nergwe gonna roll a gnome? Just play the different spectrums of the...
It's only gonna get better when I get quickened, too.
I don't know. I mean, how could I be better than Nergwe?
You could.
It's pretty hard. I mean, Nergwe is super awesome. I'm still in shock. Like, really? Am I dead?
Yeah.
Can you bring characters back? But wait a minute. Can you revive characters once they're dead?
If you. Well, no. You have to have, like, life or revive or something like that. But. Or necromancy. Necromancy would be the easiest way to return someone back to life.
Because he's not really dead. He's only mostly dead.
Oh no. Nergwe is dead.
Yeah. Now that my constitution is shot, I'm dead.
Yeah.
I'm unconscious.
True love with someone.
That's right.
Cheery. Cheery. Cry.
Is Nergwe's corpse. Is miracle magic exist in this world?
That's right.
We just need Cheery to cry on Nergwe's corpse. And the tears of true
I'm
love.
Sure. I'm sure love.
I think I heard Nergwe say to blave.
True love. Will what? Follow me for... Oh my god, my screen just went all black. Did that happen to you guys too?
No, that's just because you died.
I'm fucked up.
I still want to see Cheery fall over and start crying on the orc in the middle of battle.
Well, you guys got to avenge me first and have no one else get killed after you kill these fuckers.
Yeah.
I demand vengeance.
We got to make it out with you and all your stuff.
Damn.
And you are heavy.
Yeah, right? And as I die, all the gases leave my body, a great orc fart
That's just why.
Clears the entire room of evil. That's how I'm going to go.
I'm going to bottle some of that up. Protection from evil.
I'm confused as to how exactly. You died.
Well, hey, all right.
Sean Hiroko and Nergoy are now reunited.
Oh, I was going to say it, but I was like, ooh, that's still too soon. But, yeah,
they're in Valhalla together.
We're fighting the good fight on the other side.
That's right. That's right.
We'll bury you next to Hiroko.
Yeah, hopefully, and Ryan, I like you, but I kind of hate you right now.
He doesn't care. Cold, heartless bastard. Well, let's see if the tears of the gnome will bring you back. You're welcome.
I guess this is supposed to be a break, but
yeah.
Oh yeah, you're a morning Nergoy.
Ryan's taking a victory lap with another hard iron soda. He's like, yeah, killed him. Wow. That's why I stick to the Fosters. Cheap and big.
I guess I have to open up the old Runelord's book and church credit.
Yes. Yes, they are. It's also... Mm-hmm. I'll be right back. I gotta go mourn.
I've seen the cherry coke too.
The same company that makes one of the root beers makes a hard cherry cola.
Yeah, it's the best damn root beer, and it's really awful. The Not Your Father's is pretty good.
Yeah.
It is. It's really good. And the Coney Island is also pretty good. That is really dangerous. We're drinking Moscow Mules right now, which are also dangerous. It's, you know, it's hard cider with rum, but you don't taste the rum. So it just tastes like a light, refreshing summery drink, and then you're like, shit, what's that rum?
Yeah, you really don't taste the rum in these. That's scary. Alcohol? No. What's Shark Tank?
Thank you.
Right.
I'm back. Is Nargoy still dead?
It's like the old big what was it called? The Big Idea with Donnie Deutsch. Yeah. Okay.
You know who Mark Cuban is?
Mm-hmm.
He's one of the guys on the show that it can be one of the investor guys.
Right.
And yeah, so sometimes they'll be like, yeah, I don't know about that, and they'll like haggle with the company or... I've only seen like a couple, like a part of one episode, I think.
I've heard some people talk about it, but you know, never really elaborate on what it is. Just they thought it was a cool show. Right. It's some Japanese game show where you have to answer questions and get out before the sharks eat you or something.
I would watch that show.
Hmm. Sounds about right for Japan.
While you're in your underwear.
Yeah. Right, right. That's right.
Or singing karaoke while a girl's giving you a hand job. Yeah. Japanese robots. It's about time.
Mm-hmm. The Curse of Iceland.
Oh, yeah. People are weird.
I've seen that before. I saw it online, and somebody, I can't remember where, but somebody had posted, I can't remember if it was in a Facebook group or something like, or I read it online somewhere or something, but there's like, you can actually, well, duh, you can buy them, but I've seen the website where you can actually, like, go, like, you can shop, or the, like, you can shop through the dial, it's fascinating, I mean, it's kind of weird, but, but you can, like, yeah, like, you can shop online for, and they'll make you a doll and ship it to your house or, you know, or wherever. I know.
Sarah, I think it's time to check David's internet browser history.
That is,
Well, hang on. No, it's not so creepy anymore. Hey.
The furries? What's the furries?
Oh, Ryan, don't break his poor little world.
I don't know what any of this is.
Just Google search it.
What's it called again?
Furries.
Furries? It's going to give me pictures of a dog or something. Furry fandom, is that what it is?
Yeah.
No, it'll definitely give you pictures of furries.
Animalistic, sexy world of furries. Don't make me go to the site because I'm going to get lost in it.
Google search scritching.
It's a bunch of people dressed up in costumes.
Yeah.
Now add scritching to the search engine.
Oh,
now add what?
Scritching. Yes, I do, Ryan. Thank you.
Screeching? Is that what you...
There was a CSI episode about it.
That's where I found out about it. It was CSI, right?
Yeah, there was a CSI.
I remember that episode.
Yeah, CSI. Oh, that would be awesome. That would be awesome.
That's weird that that's a thing. I mean...
Yeah, well... You know.
It's like a, you know, super Halloween, I guess. I don't know.
Oh, my heart is... Oh, okay. I'm ready when you guys are.
David, are you done Google searching furries?
I guess so.
You'll go back to that later.
I didn't really see anything that was scandalous. I just saw a bunch of people dressed up in suits.
Yeah.
Why did Larry leave? He's missing it.
He texted me that it was trying to load and then that Crawford was still there.
Tell him to go home, Larry.
Get out. I love you. Leave. Rowan, just so you know, if you want to try it, it would be awesome. When it's your turn, you can unmute yourself and we will all be quiet and you can speak and then mute yourself again so you don't have to type. And that should probably solve everything. But it's up to you if you want to try that or not. Okay. Are we ready, folks?
Yeah, buddy.
Hell no.
Well, I'm not ready for one.
Did that corpse just talk?
That was just...
Oh,
that
man.
Was
not good yet.
Oh, now my husband walks out to give me a hug. Once game starts again, for the whole break, he's ignoring me. Like, he doesn't even care that I just died.
We had more important things to do, like look up what furries were and stuff.
Apparently.
I'm sorry you died.
Do I want to what?
You want to play Khan, my dinosaur?
No.
You
want to
play with Khan?
I do not want to play your dinosaur.
You want to play with my dinosaur?
Oh my god. You looking for more rounds?
I wish that they were muted right now.
Yeah. Yeah, really.
All right. Yeah, really. So, once I have everyone's attention, I will tell you what
attention.
Has just happened. The Tentamort has killed Nergue. And you hear a final breath escape his chest.
He's gone to Valhalla with Roko.
So how does Jack and Larissa now move forward?
Jack's pissed. And he's gonna go after Tentamort 3. Not well. And he's still too upset, I guess.
Mm-hmm. And Larissa?
Larissa's doing her best not to cry. Hang on, I'm sorry. She is going to use hydraulic push. Never mind. Now reach out and use guidance on Bors.
Bors has no weapon.
Oh shit.
He does have a weapon. Screw that. He's got his shield.
Okay. Use a guidance. On board.
He'd have to get it out. He'd have to get it out is the problem.
You feel a little sorry, Ryan?
Without your war.
Whoa.
Alright, so how does this work, Larissa?
Let me paste it again. Hang on.
Thank you. Plus one. Just have to announce it. Okay. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
He feels the surge of power.
Surge of power.
Oberon. Oh, Nergue.
Oberon, seeing his fallen friend, he's half in shock. What do I do? The rage builds within him, and he reaches into his component pouch and pulls out some sand that's multiple colors, and he just like has this wild look in his eyes, and he's just kind of like, you know, the sand in his hand swirls and swirls and starts swirling until it forms a vivid cone of clashing colors that springs forth from his hand and blinds the enemies.
Wow.
That's right.
I am publicly awarding you a fate chip.
I am
you
gonna
may not use it this game, game, but I am awarding you a fate chip.
That was amazing.
I am gonna hit all of these guys with color spray. Sorry, the bird is probably gonna get hit. I realize, but he is so incensed with anger that he's just hitting everything with color spray.
Okay.
And it's a
DC.
A vivid cone of clashing. Yeah, it's a DC. Yes. I'm sorry, you cut out.
Is it will?
It is a DC 15 will negates.
There it is. Okay.
So I guess Jack should do a will save then, huh?
Yay!
Yes.
What was the DC what?
It's 15.
Okay. Jack.
Which one is 2? Okay, good. Actually, it's more than blind. What's this hit dice? No, because if it's based on his hit dice, so what happens to him?
I think it's 1, maybe 2.
Okay. Okay, so the creature is unconscious, blinded, and stunned for 2d4 rounds, blinded and stunned for 1d4 rounds, and then stunned for 1 round after that.
Okay.
So, I don't know if you want me to roll or if you want to roll. I can roll that. 2d4. Dun 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 dun. Ooh, he's out for 5 rounds.
Wow.
And so he's unconscious, blinded, and stunned for 5 rounds, then blinded, okay, and stunned, and blinded and stunned for 2 rounds. And then stunned for another round after that.
Okay. More than enough time for the Duke to finish it off.
Yep.
All right, cool. Very cool.
And Khan.
Yep.
So now that he's out, can Khan move through that square without being attacked?
Yes.
Khan is going to move up and poison bite?
No.
So he can move up and over. Like,
yeah, okay, that's the way he did it. We're going to say he moved up and over, not the way he
did it. Yeah, up and over. Right.
Okay.
Dude. Don't fuck with the wizard.
Which one was that?
This guy.
No, he hit the top one, number 2.
But he is poisoned. Okay. He is poisoned, so he takes poison bite. Poison bite takes. Oh, come on! What is it doing? It's going crazy.
I was working on it.
Yeah, my thing is going crazy here. Poison bite injuries. For the poison, you get a it's a DC 13 against fortitude.
Failed.
Okay, so you are 1d2. Effect 1d2. Oops. So 1d2.
1d2 would be 1d4 divided by 2.
Right. So 1d4. So divide this by 2. So you lose 1 strength for. It's a frequency 1 per round for 4 rounds. Effect 1d2 strength, and you can make a saving throw each round, cure 1 save.
Okay.
So you're going to get weaker and weaker until we just kill you.
All right. So this one is poison. Tentamort 2. See, so his.
Oh,
What is Khan's AC?
It's 20.
Okay.
Fly like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
Alright, Tentamort 4. Probably, but no.
I wouldn't think so anyway, because he'd be presumably on the ground, you know?
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Right. Not a hit.
Alright. Rowan.
I'm just so full of despair. I barely know what's going on around me. I see arrows and darts and fighting on, and all I can do is look at my fallen friend, and I'm devastated. But I scream out to my god, Cade and Kaelin, how could you let this happen? You've got to make up for this. This just won't do. And I shoot my longbow at number 4.
Alright. Take it out.
Hey, Chip.
I'm so devastated, I just can't even.
Fate chip?
Oh,
yeah, you guys want to start using fate chip?
Yeah, good idea.
And don't forget you have a +1 to attack should you want to use it.
Thank you. I think I will use that. Thank you. I need help. I'm so devastated.
Oh, jeez.
That's didn't help much.
Natural 20 on that crit confirm, though.
Yeah.
Gotta keep it positive.
Here I am with a potion in my hands that could have helped my friend. And I feel horribly guilty that I was unable to do so.
All right. Cheery. Wow.
Cheery screams in rage. And starts just loosing arrows like crazy, which will translate to using my rapid shot. So I get 2 attacks, but it's -2 to both. So. Since Tentamort 3 is dead, I will shoot at Tentamort 4.
He's not dead, he's just like. Yeah.
Oh, I thought somebody finished it off after that. Okay.
No, he's out.
Oh, Khan then. Okay. Well, wait. Which one
did Khan kill? Or
Khan, okay, Khan hit and poisoned this one.
Oh, okay.
He,
okay.
Oberon knocked out this guy for like 7 rounds or something ridiculous.
So he's not going to be a threat for a while, so maybe you want to focus your attacks at some of the ones that can still cause damage.
Which one killed Nergway, though?
This one, right? 4. Oh. Team effort.
Okay, so they both attacked Nergway. All right. Well, I was already going toward Tentamort 4, so I will do at least my first one to Tentamort 4. That's not it. And again. Yeah, it's a -2, so it's 19, but I assume that's probably still hit. So 5 damage. That's all.
Alright. Bors takes his shield and swings it at Tentamort 4 and is using his benefit.
The plus one.
The plus one.
Check.
Mother father.
How did you do a negative 2?
I get a negative 4 to my roll because it's my offhand with a stinking shield.
Oh, man.
No, it wasn't. All right, the Duke. I tried.
The Duke is sticking, using this thing in front of me as a pin cushion.
Okay.
25 for the first one. For, what is that? 6 damage. All right.
Getting there. Jack.
Jack is going after 4. Ugh.
Larissa.
And Larissa. Ugh. I can occupy the same square as Jack, correct? We decided that?
Yes.
And she is going to strike out with her scythe at 4. Ugh. Yep, I know. And that is all.
Okay, Oberon. Unleash the beast. Hello? Bueller?
Oh, sorry. yeah, I'm going to move around and I am going to move in here. Actually, can I actually hit him? Before I do all this, can I actually hit this, can I hit this guy here?
Yeah.
Alright. I'm gonna hit him with Acid Dart.
Oh, I can make such a bad joke right now. Such a bad joke. Alright, you missed him.
And Khan is gonna attack... Poison bite.
Natural 20. And crit confirmed. 9 damage.
Oh, woo-hoo! Yeah.
Go, Khan.
Aw.
But he's taking damage to his strength.
Yeah.
Okay. Remember, you get minus two?
Yeah, you're going to be taking, and your modifier is plus 6, right? It's down to plus 4 now. Woohoo, little prehistoric
nope.
One. All right. Miss.
Nice.
Number 4. Good thing you've got a lot of HP.
I'm sorry, what was that? A fortitude of what? Ugh.
15.
So that's 2 off of my constitution.
One D 4.
Which means I cannot attack.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Rowan.
I'm gonna shoot at number 4 again. That's all I can do.
There we go.
And I'm going to... Where did you say... Where is the Terabuchi?
The yellow dot behind you.
Can I move back there and kick it over to Morse?
Or you can pick it up and hand it to him.
Yeah, you can pick it up and hand it to
him. I'll pick it up and hand it to him. Here you go, Boris.
Okay. He takes it.
Jesus.
And apparently nothing happens. So, Cheery, it's your turn.
going to continue rapid fire, loosing arrows. My first one will be at 10 more at 4. I get a minus 2, but I'm going to use the plus 1 guidance that I got a while ago and find a new one to use.
Blah.
So here's another one. There we go. 10 more at 4. Yeah.
All right. Boars with his great Terabuchi back in hand. Tries again. Oh, have mercy. Nice. Yeah. The Booch is back.
Yeah.
All right, guys, let's finish this. Duke.
I'm going to slip into stealth.
Okay.
No, I'm not.
You trip over your own feet as you try to sneak about. But you're still upright.
Right.
I'm being...
So,
You just look dumb.
Sure. I'm going to try to drag Nergwe back down this cave.
Do a strength check. One D20 plus your strength modifier.
Okie dokie, thank you.
What's your strength modifier?
I don't have a strength modifier.
0? Okay.
I have 10 for strength, yeah.
Okay.
In melee, yeah, I use my dexterity bonus, but not...
You tug at his armor, and his body doesn't move.
Okay, now they're going to think I'm filching the armor. Great. Great.
All right. Jack and Larissa.
Larissa's going to take a 5-foot step back. And Jack is going to attack.
Why is that seems to be the pattern?
I don't know. As long as at least one's hitting.
Alright, Larissa.
Larissa just moved back because she's sick.
Okay. Obi.
Alright. Umbreon is going to move up. Yeah. And. Ooh, do a little dance apparently. And acid dart this guy in front of me. Or not. And Khan is going to attack. Bite.
Nice. 5 damage. Oh, man. Tentamore 2. Yeah.
Ooh, nope. Swing and a miss.
That's working out well. Rowan.
I'm gonna shoot at Tantamount to Tentamount. Oh, sorry.
Natural 20. Doesn't confirm, but you did do 6 damage.
Nice.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Oh my god.
Cheery.
Wow.
Still, it's an arrow, so still doing the rapid shot, so first one, yeah. That's it.
Not for long. Force. Force steps forward, grinding his boot on the dead body of the Tentamort that was in front of him, and swings his great Terabuchi. Come on, Booch. 17.
Boars, do you see any more of them?
Say that again?
Do you see any more of them?
It looks clear.
Cherry runs up and hugs Nergrith's body.
Larissa does the same.
It's my fault. It's all my fault.
I was preparing the right wounds too, Rowan. I was ready. The spell wasn't quite ready yet. I was trying.
And I got him sick earlier with this stupid scimitar. I take out the scimitar and I touch Nergway with it. I'm so sorry, my friend.
Hmm.
Larissa's quietly sobbing.
Duke.
Oh, please.
The Duke.
If there is, if...
Go ahead. Sorry.
Kate and Kaylin, if you have any power at all, please bring it forth for our friend right now.
Duke rips off a piece of her cape and places it over Nergoy's eyes. Death comes to us all. What should we do now?
It was much too soon for Nergoy.
Death comes too soon for all of us. And she's sitting there on her knees. She tried to move Nergoy, could not. So,
yeah. And Oberon and Larissa, as you're standing where you're standing, and also Bors sees and realizes as well, but to your right, to the east, is an opening out to the sky, to the ocean 30 feet below, and the fresh air is coming into the cavern, and you're just, this is the scene around you.
Well, we can, I don't know the ways of orcs. I'm not familiar with their customs, but we could give Nergoy a watery burial.
No.
Better than leaving him in this terrible place.
To become a goblin food. And I don't think we should take him all the way back to Sandpoint either. We've already cleared out this much of this area.
Burning the body would be unwise. If that is their custom, it would just attract more
goblins or other creatures at this point. I agree.
The best thing that we could do is shave his head, take his stuff, and bury him at sea, as you suggest. We can burn the hair, and we can let the ashes go where you let your friend go, on that hilltop.
If there's something down in that hoarding room that we could lay him on, as the room to float out there, I could shoot a burning arrow out once we get him floating on the water. That, I don't know how far down the water is, if that's feasible.
Yeah.
30 feet.
I don't know.
So Rowan.
So we can't.
Those of you who can't, haven't seen it, I just want to point out, Rowan is, as you're talking, tucking the scimitar into the armor of Nergoy, strapping it, tucking it in, whatever, close to his body for burial.
So, don't want to be a dick, but should we search this too soon? I mean, I don't...
Why can't we take him back? Why can't we take him back to town?
It's a long journey. Like, out of character, it's a long way back to Tipperary, so...
It is.
Well, I mean, I'm sorry, Allie, go ahead.
I'm just afraid this whole place will be replenished with goblins if we...
I agree with Cheery. Unfortunately, we still have a mission.
What is that mission?
To clear out this area of goblins that keep attacking.
Rowan, roll a perception check for me. Ten is close enough. You're right there. As you're on your knees tucking the scimitar into Nergway's armor and strapping it to his body, you notice that there is what seems to be water forming on the scimitar. And you hear a light weeping sound coming from it.
Okay, the sword's alive. But
you know, this is, you know, you're just in this crazy battle, you know, your friend is dead. Your friend is dead. And you're all shaken. So, you know, could be, couldn't be. Might be your mind playing tricks on you. Who knows? But either way, this is a terrible situation. And you are in the midst of an unknown area with who knows what's now behind you and yet in front of you. And got to decide what you're going to do as a group as far as try to haul this body into the unknown with you or dispose of it and move on.
No, Oberon doesn't want to leave his friend behind.
We can't very well carry him through all of this.
Well,
the best thing to do would probably be to just say our goodbyes here.
Well, so, you say your goodbyes and I'll carry him back.
The Duke looks up and she's kind of got water in her eyes looking at Oberon. We can bring him upstairs. Lock him in one of the rooms. Come back down. Clear out the rest of this place. This little, you know, and then burn it down as we leave with him.
Rowan says that we shouldn't move yet.
There's a horse upstairs.
Yeah, there's a horse that can carry him.
At least we could take him back to Sandpoint at that point, and they could perform the rites and rituals of his kind. But we can at least drag him upstairs and lock him in a room so that nothing gets to him as we come down and finish the mission, and then just burn this place to the ground. But I haven't known him that long. I haven't. The less than a week that I've known all of you, you know, you guys are kind of like friends and stuff, and you guys care for each other. I don't think you just want to toss him into the water or leave him here for goblin food.
Surely his bravery and his honor are evident.
But we can't sit here.
No, we cannot, unfortunately.
Well, I am going to drag him. If nobody else will, I'll do the deed. I'll step up.
We can take him back to...
We take him together.
We can get him back to Sandpoint. And...
So can we say at this point that we're going to take Nergway upstairs, lock him in the pickle room, and come back down and continue on?
We're going to put him in the pickle room?
Well, no, I'm just saying, any of the rooms up there that we can actually lock. Like, lock, you know?
We don't want to hear...
We're not listening to evil, that's why.
The mercenary's room has a bed, right? Or one of the rooms with a bed. And there are, like, bedrooms, so we might be able to lock one of them.
Lock the door. Well, not the mercenary's room, because you have a way to door off.
Do we have a way to lock anything?
I don't know.
I don't have a spell for that. Oberon, do you have a spell that we could put on the door so that it's not disturbed?
The most I can do is close the door. I don't really have a way. I don't have any magical traps or anything prepared, so I can't really do anything in that respect. But
what about you? Are you good at setting any traps?
I'm sorry, what?
Are you good at setting traps?
Set
a trap at the door to protect our friend until we can get him a proper burial.
We could put him in the one at the end of the hallway and just take a bunch of stuff from the porter room and put it in front of the door, maybe. Hopefully we'll be here too much longer.
To answer Larissa's question, I do not have trap setting. Out of character, I don't have trap setting.
Okay. But
in character, the Duke says, I'm not really good at setting traps. I don't have the material to even set one if I knew how to do one. It takes time and everything like that. I mean, I'm just trying to think
of ideas. I really think the likelihood of the body being disturbed is probably pretty slim.
Look at chat, y'all.
We are.
Who said that?
I think, you know, Oberon, I remember that ghost you had that was collecting things, and could you possibly, or maybe Rowan, you have the ability to create one of those to watch over his body and at least tell us if it's being disturbed, I guess? I don't know.
No, I can't. It only works within a certain distance, so if I leave it, if I walk away too far, it'll just blink out.
Gotcha. I really think the chance of it being disturbed is pretty slim. We've already cleared out this whole upper area.
They'd so what are we supposed to do, just clear out?
Yeah.
We just supposed to clear out goblins or something from this?
And get to Thistletop, too.
I was trying to remember, too. What was it we were supposed to do specifically at Thistletop?
You are here to clear out the threat to Sandpoint.
Just clear, okay. I didn't know if there was more to that whole crazy succubus lady thing that we were, I guess, investigating the problem as well.
Right, exactly.
So I think if we leave Nergue, Larissa gets really choked up as she says the name. Name kind of gets caught in her throat. In one of the rooms, he'll be safe, and we can give him a proper burial when we get back to Sandpoint.
Sure.
Is that good for everybody?
Boris says I'll carry him to that really nice bedroom back the way we came. But he wouldn't want us standing here arguing over top of him.
So we carry him back to the bedroom.
Okay. Let's see here. Well, as a team we do. So it happens. So he's gone. And he is left here.
We could probably just continue from where we were, go back there, and carry on. Does anybody need healing?
Jack does. Larissa does.
I'll hand Larissa.
I have a potion. I don't know if Rowan has the ability to heal all of us.
Well, I don't think all of us are injured. Listen, I found this potion on the mercenary. Why don't you and Jack take it? The potion of cure moderate wounds.
Thank you, Duke. I'll take it. Will it cure my nausea?
No.
I didn't think so.
But that lasted.
That was like 2 rounds. So
it's gone.
Can you take away my squiggly?
Throw up on my feet. Because that's what you did to Hiroko. Before he died.
So what's moderate wounds? I have to look it up.
Here. I made myself a button. 14.
Oh, that's more than enough, yeah.
Anybody else?
Yeah, I could use some healing.
Oh, wow.
Too soon. Look,
the
that
dead
was
speaks.
Wrong.
Huh. I have a potion of cure light wounds I can give to Jack. Can you push the button for Jack for light wounds?
Sure.
More than enough for him, too. Very nice. All right, Boris, I guess this time you need to lead.
Who will take up the rear now?
Wow.
So Boris leads, well, first continues up into this area.
I'll take up the rear.
And actually, let me, while we're at it, tell you what we see in the room we're in, because we didn't really do that before stuff hit the fan. The floor of this cavern seems strangely polished and smooth. To the east, a thick curtain of vines and nettles hang down over a wide opening overlooking the Eurasian Gulf. So there were some things, but still, you can see through it. And then the next room. Reveal areas. Moves in. This room. Dozens of strange dead bodies lie scattered about this room. Most are seabirds and ospreys, but there are 6 dead goblins here as well. Each body is literally skin and bones, as if all of the interior organs and muscles have somehow been drained away, leaving behind skeletons draped with leathery, slowly rotting skin.
Ugh. So Larissa joins Boris up here.
Mm-hmm.
Looks around and says, what happened here?
This looks like this could have possibly been all of our ends had we not come out successful. We definitely need to be careful as we move forward.
And suddenly feeling nauseous again, but not because of any ill effects of the sting she received. Larissa backs back out and tells everybody else that there's no need to go down that way. There's no need. Nobody needs to see that.
and tells her about the bodies. And
do any of you decide to go ahead and go into that area, regardless of Larissa's warning of you don't want to go in there? Sean was away from the keyboard.
This to them thoroughly?
Well, Bors is going to search the room, but I'm asking, I guess, does anyone else want to search it with him, or is he doing it by himself?
Hang on, so
he's doing it by himself.
I'm going to go into the Bors, and Bors to find a bunch of dead goblins up here, and so we've got to go and search the room, of course.
Search the room!
All right, Sean, the Duke wants to go up and search the room, of course.
I figured that would be the case, so, okay.
Here he's going to go keep watch over here and make sure nothing's coming this way.
Is that a dirty look for your mother? What?
All right. So, Bors and the Duke.
Yeah, I'm awful.
Come across on the goblin bodies. Most of their weapons are rusty heaps, but one of the bodies, the carcass still wears a suit of very nice armor, but it's a hide armor, and it's obviously small, but they take it for Cheery or whatever, just in case. And it bears a ruined horse chopper as well, but leaves that behind. But it does have a masterwork short bow that they also confiscate to offer, and if not, Bors will leave it behind. But Bors is thinking of the others. I can't speak for the Duke.
What?
Yeah. The items in the room that were found are basically a small hide armor.
Right, a short bow.
And a masterwork short bow.
Yeah.
Don't think that's anything the Duke would be interested in, but...
Nope.
Nope.
No, but you said we were going to take it for Cheery.
Yeah, well, Bors is saying, let's take this to Cheery to see if she's interested or anyone else is interested. And otherwise, we'll drop it and continue on.
Sounds like a plan.
Okay. So he comes and brings that to Cheery, wherever she's at. Woo, there she is.
Down the hall.
Can you, I can't see myself. Can someone show me?
I'll pretty much, take it, but obviously I'll have to look them up to see if they're any better than what I have or whatever. But we'll say I take it.
You notice that the hide armor is made of dog skin.
Never mind.
You're like, I don't know that that's gonna work for me.
No, thank
you. But the short bow, the masterwork short bow is... Nice.
I'll take it for now and...
Okay. Alright. So Bors says, let's continue on. Everyone in agreement?
Yes.
Yep.
Alright. Yes.
So he pushes forward. And... there's a hallway leading north, and a hallway leading back south, which is the way we came. And there is also a doorway straight ahead. And he calls that back to anyone who hears. Well, no, he calls that semi-quietly back to Cheery, who I would hope would relay that back.
Yes.
Okay. So, Allie relays that. Oberon, what are you doing?
Following and sulking.
Yep. Rowan? Following, Following and crying. Sean.
I'm bringing up the rear.
All right. Your new position.
Kitty style.
Do we go right or straight, guys?
Let's go right. I say from the rear.
I said right as well and just realized I was muted.
Oh, okay. So Boris goes upward. And looks around. Wow. Small room, big description. The lower 4 feet of the walls in this empty room are covered with crude drawings in mud, blood, and paint. Most of the drawings show goblins engaged in some sort of violence against humans, horses, or dogs. One picture on the north wall is at least 3 times the size and complexity of the other scrawlings. This image shows Thistletop from the side, the goblin stockade perched atop it like a crown. A cave has been drawn into the center of the image, and looming inside is what appears to be an immense, muscular goblin with snake-like eyes and a dog slicer in each taloned hand. If the scale compared to the rest of the drawing is to be believed, this goblin must be at least 30 feet tall.
Yikes. So that's what Boris saw, correct?
Yeah. And he sees it and kind of, he takes it in, doesn't pay it a lot of heed, and stands and waits for everyone to catch up.
So
let's see where
Larissa comes in.
Okay.
But looks around and sees the huge drawing. And looks at Boris, and I go, I hope that's not how big he really is.
Mm-hmm.
Some sort
I'm
of
sure
goblin.
It isn't.
God.
I've never heard of a goblin that big. And Allie?
No, I've seen pretty big Boris.
I'm going to move up and call down there. Is it just another room, or is there...
No, it looks like there's a hallway.
Okay. If we're gonna go down that way first, then I'll come up. We'll come up and look at the goblin, and hopefully that's just some sort of legend or goblin god or something. And I'll come up and wait for the rest of the
group. All right. Khan and Oberon.
Go and follow up and actually go up here and make room.
All right. Rowan? Okay. Moving on up.
I can read and speak goblin, so is there anything intelligible written?
That is a good question.
Well, I hope you have a good answer.
I do too. I don't have it right at this very second, but I will get it for you.
So I'm just trying to read the writing on the wall.
Oh.
No. I mean, it's just there's no writing because goblins don't write. And it's just the pictures that they've painted that I've described. So.
Can I make any sense of it? Is it like a story or is it just...
No, they're all individual little things for the most part, except for the one that's just a big drawing of the monster goblin.
Okay, thank you.
Yep. Duke.
Is this a door that's right here?
Yes, it's a double door.
I'm going to check it for traps.
Okay.
29.
You find no traps. Do you have knowledge of religion? No, you don't. But you do, as you're inspecting the door, see a scene that is depicted on the doors. But you can't make it out as to what it's supposed to represent.
I have knowledge of religion.
Out of character.
I'll join the... Oh, do you want me to wait, or can I join the rest
of
the
group? No, go ahead. Go ahead.
So there's a door back there with this crazy picture on it. I don't know what it means and stuff. Holy crap, is that a giant goblin?
Awesome.
Are we really here to fight that?
Well, we're hoping that's not real.
Boris says, I doubt it.
Okay.
They wish.
So which way do you guys want to go next?
So did you or did you not, out of character, tell what you saw?
No, I ran in and I said that there's a door back there with some crazy pictures on it that I don't understand. And then I said, holy crap, is that a giant goblin?
I want to go see if I can interpret the drawings or the writing.
I'll go with it.
I will go too, because I think I have some religion knowledge.
Me too. I have knowledge of Arcana.
Cora says, I'll stay here and take up the rear.
We're flip-flopping now. It's the Duke in the lead, Boar's in the rear. Boar's taking the lead, Duke's in the rear. Boar style, kitty style.
Should we all just roll for it?
Roll for it. Everyone with applicable knowledge. Religion 14. Nope.
12.
Nope. Who is this? Cheery.
Yes.
Larissa and Rowan recognize the images to depict things that have to do with churches and religion and whatnot, but some of the symbols they can't quite make out and understand. They haven't quite seen those before. But Shiri recognizes those symbols perfectly clear. They are... the scene is a common scene to churches of Lamashtu, the god Lamashtu, which we have heard about many times before.
Was that in regards to
our friend, the crazy lady?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I have a silver holy symbol of Lamashtu.
Mm-hmm.
On my person.
Mm-hmm. The crazy lady.
So, that is the graphic before you. So, a church symbol to Lamashtu.
I wonder if this is some kind of chapel.
Yeah, kind of the connection you make as out of character, a person would see a steeple and a cross and whatnot. You would connect that to a Christian church. You know, only typically seen on a church. You know, a steeple specifically. So this is the equivalent of that. It's like, basically, it's got "Welcome to the Church of Lamashtus" painted on this door. So, yeah, that's what
I will realizing. Relate that to the
Okay. Okay.
Hmm.
Or says, "I'm not interested in going to church. I'm interested in getting revenge."
I'm all about the revenge right now, and I know Jack is. He's hungry.
Well, there might be some enemies in the church.
That is true.
But, I mean, we started going the other way. We can go the other way first. Whatever, we're going to go through all of it, right? So, whichever way.
Are you leading Duke, or am I?
You're leading.
Okay. And we're going this way. And he starts to walk through the... And he reveals a room. And he steps forward. And he waits.
And the rest of follows cautiously. Mm-hmm. As does Jack.
These were open doors, by the way, so that's why there was no stopping to check for traps or anything. Just open passageways. So, everyone following?
Yes. Yep. Take it okay. Up the rear.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, this is what he sees in this room. A large table surrounded by chairs fills much of this room. A slate board to the north is covered with scribblings in chalk, but the map of Sandpoint that has been carefully inscribed on it leaves no doubt as to the purpose of this room. This is doubtless where the recent raid was planned.
Hey, I bet this is where the recent raid was planned.
It does seem to be a war room of sorts. And... as you all enter the area, and I'll move Boars further in so you can see, and come into the room if you wish.
And I'll further search the room.
And I will check the doors for traps.
Yep, that's what I was going to say. There is now revealed a door here, and a door here.
Okay.
Both closed. So, the Duke, as you check the doors for traps,
do you want me to roll or?
Yep.
Mm. 32.
You perceive no traps.
And then I'm going to do it on this one up here.
Yep.
30.
You perceive no traps.
Okay. Are either locked?
The one in front of you is not. The one here is.
Okay. I will say this door up here where I'm bouncing back and forth, guys, is not locked. I'm going to work on this lock.
Okay.
And, yeah. Do you want me to do that now, or do you want to move on, or... I have fast pick, so...
Go ahead and work on it.
Why don't we check out...
I didn't unlock it there. Don't worry about it. Proceed, and I'll come back to you.
Okay. What do you think, guys? Which way should we go?
Now we should probably find out what's behind these doors. I mean, there's a reason why that one's locked.
Yeah, let's check the other one while the Duke's working on that.
All right, so Wars walks up to this one and opens it. And reveals that it is just a staircase leading back upstairs.
Is this one of the staircases we found?
This is the equivalent staircase to the one Sly found.
Okay.
We are right below the bathroom.
I was going to say, I think it was near a bathroom if anyone needs to see.
Boris hears what Rowan says and says, no, we're not ready to leave yet.
I'm sorry, what did we find? The bathroom?
That's the staircase that leads back upstairs.
Leads to the bathroom.
Yeah, we are directly underneath that bathroom that Sly found, and the staircase leading downward, where the treasure was hidden.
Mm-hmm.
By the courtyard.
Yeah.
So that's where we're at.
Okay.
So, all right. So Duke, have you...
23 to disable device.
So you unlock the door.
Sweet. Boris, would you like to do the honors? And I'll move back.
And Boris comes up. And he's not feeling super... No, that's not right. He's not emotional about this. He's still careful. He slowly pushes the door open to reveal a woman inside.
Hmm? We're here to investigate the threat from the standpoint. What are you doing in a lair full of goblins?
Waiting for Sue to open.
Yeah,
we've been waiting a long time.
Yeah. What have you done to him? He broke his own neck, actually. It was really weird.
I remember that. That's awesome.
Maybe he was depressed. Well, you know, he kind of sounded like he'd been here for a while, and he didn't seem like the kind of guy who had a lot of friends.
See that, Christian?
It's time to talk to him, actually.
Yeah, we didn't really get good conversation with the guy. He sort of was, you know, kind of
he threatened
aggressive.
Us.
Yeah. Oh, get off it. Go sit down, you wench.
Fireball.
Fireball.
And I'm over here.
How convenient.
Huh.
No one has done anything on either side other than talk at this point. So until
just chill out.
Until
chill
someone out. On either side yanks out a weapon and starts to move forward, I'm not rolling initiative.
Yeah.
Do you mean any harm to Sandpoint? Are you?
It's sort of a straightforward question, you know. We're not trying to play games. We just want to know.
Well,
there's goblins that attack Sandpoint, and we're there to protect it, so we want to know it.
We're kind of in Sandpoint, so it's kind of our concern.
Yeah.
Evil, have you read what this lady's MO at all, or what? Okay, good. Okay. All right, continue. Unpause.
You know you're not his only lady.
Oh, my.
Ooh.
Well, you know, to look at you.
He was your first concern.
He's definitely not a friend.
And we need to give her a minute. To... Ooh, Boris, I think she likes you.
Wow, Ryan. Out of character.
I think we're getting a little off topic here.
Boris yeah. moves into the room. Are you going to tell us what you're doing here or not? All right, we'll glean the information off of your dead body then.
No, we won't, Boris. No, we won't, Boris.
Take her captive.
Yeah, let's tie her up and...
Why is Boris starting a fight?
Good questioning.
Okay, fine!
You want Boris to go first? This is what happens.
Yeah, really? He doesn't think about things. He just does.
Listen, our friend is kind of stupid. Our friend is kind of dumb.
He's got his therapy in hand.
He's having a bad day. His friend just died. We just want to talk.
Jeez.
Okay, we can do. Boris all right, we can. Die.
Do you
no,
realize
Boris,
you're at a disadvantage?
Boris is not going to die. I'll put this lady down.
No,
she's not
no.
going to do anything.
No. Who here is the best move?
His computer just died. So we don't know what he wants to know. Who's the best of what?
Who's the best mood?
Maybe diplomacy or something?
I'm the best looking.
Who's the best what? We got...
Smooth talker.
Oh, smooth talker. We got... Yeah.
I
who's
am
got
very
the best diplomacy?
I
know
I'm
you are.
I'm skilled at bluffing. I can bluff the Duke with a -2 to my charisma.
I hate you.
I can try diplomacy.
I have a 2 in diplomacy, so I'm probably not the best.
I've got a 4.
I have a 4.
So, we know who's the best, but we don't know what we're supposed to do with it.
No.
If he was even saying diplomacy.
Try to convince her to help out.
I tried to convince the group that I was a good negotiator, but that failed.
Rowan has a 4.
The Duke rolls her eyes at you from the back.
Is that a skill check?
Please tell me Tara is rolling a new character.
Is she?
I don't know. She's not even part of the group anymore, the chat. So
I know.
What
I
is
know.
She doing out there, David? Is she
because
just,
she died. No,
I'm
she's.
I'm just
going to
drink
she...
myself away with the Moskel mules.
Yeah, she was doing something out there. She was
she's just drinking
the
vodka. She's
she
like,
was
I'm
sad that
this.
She died. I can't believe she died. What the hell is that?
It's called gameplay. It happens.
Gameplay.
It happens. It happens.
Yeah, hey, man, we've had two people die already.
Hey,
man.
Guys. Hey, guys. GM says this is a good point with his computer being down to call it a night.
What?
It's going to take him a while for it to boot back up, so.
Uh-oh.
Well, first, tell me what time of day it is.
What time of day is it?
It's dungeon.
He's going to have to get back to you on that.
Okay.
And I have a message for Evil.
Please change where the players are at to the row of...
Yeah,
we can all hear him.
The background to the photo of Thistletop. Move the players and.
Good game, everybody. Except
that?
It was sad.
Good game, except for Nairgway.
Give Nairgway a big hug for us all.
We miss Nairgway.
We'll bury him proper.
Good night, everybody.
I won't use cool, ashes man. For kitty litter.
Ryan, talking to you. Ryan.
Thistletop. Yeah. You got your Thistletop there, brother?
Say that three times quick.
When did you get your lisp? You stop looking at my head here, Sean. Alright,
Alright, so that's what it is, guys.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Good night.
David, good pass game. On our,
That was a horrible game!
It was a great game.
It was a good game.
It was terrible. It was terrible.
You killed my sister! You're sleeping on the couch tonight! I didn't do it, that's why I hired Ryan to do it! What? Oh, that didn't help. So, Christian, good luck with that. Sleeping on the couch. I hope it's comfy. And
says he hopes the couch is comfy.
Ryan, good job.
No, he's things. Evil.
That's his duty. That's his old.
He sucks.
Yeah, and you could be thinking like, oh, Christian, you killed my sister. That's why Ryan's here. So there's no emotional baggage.
That's right. So we have somebody to hate.
Good night, guys.
Good night, Maria. Are you sick? Oh, she left. Oh, and everybody's gone except me, Ryan, and Allie. So good job, little brother. You're an evil little man. Have you played Pokemon Go yet? Oh, I'm sorry that your phone is stupid. Yeah. I don't know. I really don't know what to do. Just call Christian and ask him. How do I do this? Just kill us all. Anyway, good luck with that. Right. That would probably be best. Do you have his phone? Well, he doesn't answer his phone. Yeah, just text him and ask him. What's up? So cool. All right, little man. I'll talk to you later. All right, love you, buddy. I believe Allie is making fried green tomato sandwiches. And after that, I'm going to try to convince her to go play Pokemon Go in the park. So yeah. Ooh.
Wow.
Oh, nice. And you're like, I've had good meat. I've had good drink. I'm going to kill the half orc. Boom. All right, buddy. Have a great night, man. I'll see you in a little bit. Bye.